I, Bertolt Brecht, came out of the Black Forest. My mother moved me into the cities as I lay inside her body. And the coldness of the forest will be inside me till my dying day.
The cities were built for you. They are eager to welcome you. The doors of the houses are wide open, and the meal is ready on the table. As the cities are very big, experts have drawn maps for those who do not know the program, showing clearly the quickest way to reach one's goal. As no one knew exactly what you wanted, you are of course expected to make suggestions. Here or there, there may be some little thing that's not quite to your taste. This will be put right immediately, without you having to lift a finger. In short, you are in the best possible hands. Everything is completely ready, and all you need do is come.
Why are you so late?
Now, just a minute.
No, not you. You can clear out. We know you. No use your trying to shove your way in here.
Stop. Where do you think you're going? Some of you there. Would you be kind enough to hit him? That's it. Now he's got the idea.
What? Still jabbering, is he? Right then, let him have it.
He's always jabbering. Just show the fellow what it's all about. If he thinks he can kick up fuss over the least little thing, hit him again. You might as well do him while you're about it. That's it. When you've done him proper, you can bring in what's left of him. We'll hold on to that.
The guests you see here have plates and cups. You were given a plate only, and when you asked what time the tea would be served, they said, after the meal.
There are those who move half a street away. The walls are distempered after them. They are never seen again. They eat other bread. Their women lie under other men with the same size. On bright, fresh mornings, faces and linen can be seen hanging from the same window as before.
Often at night, I dream I can no longer own my living.
Like a stranger.
Nobody in this country
slept with
tables I made.
Greets me politely on the landing.
Fishmongers passes by
smiling.
I know that the last room
the linen
where
hanging out to dry in the yard is my linen.
Furniture has
I know
been cleaned
well.
Away.
Looking closer, however, I see darns in it and extra patches. It seems I have moved
curtains
out.
Torn down.
Someone else is living here
short,
and doing so in my linen.
To make my unhappy face go pale.
If you had read the papers as carefully as I do, you would have given up hope that things may yet get better. No one dies of his own accord. And what use was the war? True, we got rid of a few people. But how many were begotten? And we can't even put on a war like that every year. What can a hurricane do? Take the effect of two hurricanes on Miami and all Florida. First reports say 50,000 dead. Then the next day it turns out to be 3,700. You can surely replace that any day. Even for those who live in Miami, it's a minimal relief. Let alone for those of us who live so far away from it. It's practically an insult. Are we now to be insulted as well? At least we deserve the right to an undisturbed bitterness.
Sit down. Are you seated? You can lean right back. You are to sit comfortably and at ease. You may smoke. It is important that you should hear me quite distinctly. Can you hear me distinctly? I have something to tell you that you will find of interest.
You are a flathead. Can you really hear me? I do hope there's no question of you not hearing me loud and clear. Well then, I'll repeat. You are a flathead. F as in Freddie, L as in Louie, A as in Annie, T as in Tommy, and head as in head. Flathead. Please, don't interrupt me. Don't interrupt me. You are a flathead. Don't say anything, no excuses. You are a flathead, period. I'm not the only one that says so. Your respected mother has been saying it all along. You are a flathead. Just ask your relations if you're not an F. Everyone around you has known for years. You are an F.
It's characteristic that you should deny it. That's just the point. It's characteristically F to deny it. Oh, it's terribly hard to get a flathead to admit he's an F. It's really exhausting. Look, sooner or later, it's got to be said that you are an F. It isn't entirely uninteresting to know what you are, after all. It's a positive drawback not knowing what everyone knows. Oh, you think you see things just like the other chap. But he's a flathead too. Please don't comfort yourself that there are other Fs. You are an F.
It's not too terrible. It won't stop you living to 80. In business, it's a positive advantage. And as for politics, invaluable. As an F, you have nothing to worry about. And you are an F. That's pleasant, isn't it? You still don't get it. Who else do you want to tell you? Brecht, too, says you're an F. Come on, Brecht, give him your professional opinion.
The man is thy F.
Well then, this record needs to be played more than once.
If you want to be a big shot, start by learning to be tough, 'cause you'll never hit the jackpot till you like the going rough. All the little shots below you can be blown away like fluff, if they realize when they know you that you won't take all their guff.
As I walk through their cities, seeking a living, I am told, show us what you're made of. Lay it on the table, deliver the goods. Say something to inspire us. Tell us of our own greatness, divine our secret desires. Show us the way out, make yourself useful, deliver the goods. Stand alongside us so that you tower over us. Show that you are one of us. We'll make you our hero. Oh, we can pay you too. We have the wherewithal. No one else has. Deliver the goods. Know that our great showmen are those who show us what we want to have shown. Dominate by serving us. Endure by winning duration for us. Play our game. We'll share the loot. Deliver the goods. Be straight with us.
Deliver the goods.
When I look into their decomposing faces, my hunger disappears.
I am an old woman. When pension rates were cut, my children gave me the few pennies they could spare. But I could hardly afford to buy anything now. So at first I went less often to the shops where I had gone daily. But one day I thought it over. And then, daily once more, I went to the baker's, greengrocer's, as an old customer. With care I picked my provisions. Took no more than I used to, but no less either. Put rolls beside the loaf and leeks beside the cabbage. And only when they added up the bill did I sigh, with stiff fingers dig into my little purse and, shaking my head, confess that I didn't have enough to pay for those few things. And shaking my head, I left the shop, observed by all the customers. I said to myself, if all of us who have nothing no longer turn up where food is laid out, they may think we don't need anything. But if we come and are unable to pay, they'll know how it is.
Again and again, when I look at this man, he hasn't taken a drop. And he laughs as he used to. I think it's getting better. Spring is coming. Good times are coming. The times that have gone have returned. Love is beginning again. Soon things will be the way they once were. Again and again, I have been chatting with him. He has eaten supper and doesn't go out. He is speaking to me and hasn't got his hat on. I think it'll be all right. Ordinary times are over. One can talk to a chap. He listens. Love is beginning again. Soon, things will be the way they once were. The rain never falls upwards. Once the wound stops hurting, what hurts is the scar.
Afterwards, he laughed and said, it's the bath salts, not your hair. But he was an easy catch. For a whole month, I left as soon as he'd had me. I held off every third day. I never worked. But try keeping snow in a saucepan. It turns dirty without any help. I went on doing the best I could, even when it was over. I chucked out the tarts who infested his bed, as if it was part of the arrangement. I did it laughing, and I did it crying. I turned on the gas 5 minutes before he got home. I borrowed money in his name. It didn't do any good. But one night, I went to sleep. And one morning, I got up. Washed all over from head to foot, ate and said to myself, that's that. Actually, I slept with him twice more. But by God and my mother, there was nothing to it. As everything passes, so did that.
I had just turned 16 that season when you came up from Burma to stay. And you told me all to travel with me. You were sure to hear what you said to me.
much meaner than you. Surabaya, Johnny.
My God. And I still love you so.
Surabaya, Johnny. Why am I feeling so blue? You have no heart, Johnny. And I still love you so.
I speak my lines before the audience hears them. What they will hear is something done with. Every word that leaves the lip describes an arc and then falls on the listener's ear. I wait and hear the way it strikes. I know we're not feeling the same thing, and we're not feeling it at the same time.
Surabaya, Johnny.
Oh my God, I still love you so. And I always thought the very simplest words must be enough. When I say what things are like, everyone's heart must be torn to shreds. That you'll go down if you don't stand up for yourself. Surely you see that.
Surabaya, Johnny.
When you see someone fulfilling his purpose, especially if that be self-destruction, you can't say, hey, I've got a better idea, because you haven't.
You have no heart, Johnny.
There's a time when you have to choose between being human and having good taste.
And I still love you so.
This then is all. It's not enough, I know. At least I'm still alive, as you may see. I'm like the man who took a brick to show how beautiful his house used once to be.
Give up your dream that they will make an exception in your case. What your mother's told you binds no one. Keep your contracts in your pockets. They will not be on it here. Give up your hopes that you are all destined to finish up chairman. Get on with your work. You will have to pull yourselves together if you are to be tolerated in the kitchen. You still have to learn the ABC. The ABC says they will get you down. Do not think about what you have to say. You will not be asked. There are plenty of mouths for the meal. What's needed here is commitment.
Not that anyone should be discouraged by that.
Truly, I live in dark times. The guileless word is folly. A smooth forehead suggests insensitivity. The man who laughs has simply not yet heard the terrible news. What kind of times are they when a talk about trees is almost a crime because it implies silence about so many horrors? That man there, calmly crossing the street, is perhaps already beyond the reach of his friends who are in need. It is true I still earn my keep, but believe me, that is only an accident. Nothing I do gives me the right to eat my fill. By chance, I've been spared. If my luck breaks, I am lost. They say to me, eat, drink, be glad you have it. But how can I eat when what I eat is snatched from the starving? And my glass of water belongs to one who is dying of thirst. And yet I eat and drink. I would like also to be wise. The old books say what wisdom is, to shun the strife of the world and to live out our brief time without fear. Also to get along without violence, to return good for evil. Not to fulfill desires, but to forget them is accounted wise. All this I cannot do. Truly, I live in dark times.
In the dark times, will there also be singing?
Yes, there will also be singing about the dark times.
Oh, the shark has
everything changes, you can make a fresh start with your final breath.
But what has happened has happened.
And the water you once poured into the wine cannot be drained off again.
What has happened has happened.
The water you once poured into the wine cannot be drained off again.
But everything changes. You can make a fresh start with your final breath.